anything to get solution. So what solution we get? That's most important thing. This group discussion is not new to this world. Actually, in the ancient period also, people have that kind of attitude at home itself. Whenever we see any family crisis come, our elders used to gather at one place and find out the solution for it. That's called group discussion indeed. So here we can see how actually the group discussion things will work out for the purpose of recruitment. Especially the recruitment is very important these days, so that in the recruitment process, what they are seeing. So anybody know that what actually look for recruiting people there? What they look for in anyone? What they look for?
Skills.
Yeah, the skills. The skills in the sense, what skills here, especially nonverbal communication, at the same time verbal communication. Verbal communication, nonverbal communication skills. Verbally, you are right. But nonverbally, sometimes you may not be, because our emotions must be controlled. Always, we can't meet the people whoever are there around us. The people may be from different places, especially at workplace. It's totally difficult. The people who are there for 4 years, they may not be there for 4 years in your life. After 4 years. So at the workplace, you are going to see different kind of people from different areas, different states, different localities, different languages. So at the time, how you are going to cope up with those people? That's important for those recruiters. So here the group discussion is one kind here, discussing. At same time, it's a kind of case study also. Case study is one thing here, they give a situation. Two kind of things are there. Group discussion is one thing and case study discussion is one thing. It's called decision making. When the situations are totally away from us at the time, when you are there at the position, what you are going to do it, that's called case study. So a crisis is given to you and they expect a solution from you. That is also one test. Some recruiters are asking that, and some recruiters are asking group discussion. Whatever it is, they are going to find in you the communication skills, language skills, and nonverbal communication, right? More than that, apart from all these, they are going to find out a leader in you. Whether there are leaders or not in you, leadership qualities are there in you or not. Speaking is different. Whenever a crisis comes, whenever a situation occurs abruptly, unexpectedly, at the time, how you are going to face it and how you are going to lead your life, right, without any hesitation, without any stress and, all right, depression. Because it is common. Everybody can't be happy in 100 years of life. 1 year or the other year, or definitely everybody faces some crisis. So at the time, how you are able to, right, stand by yourself and how you are going to support your subordinates and your colleagues. That's very important here. That's what, how you are able to control your stress, how you are able to control your depression, how you are able to control your, right, emotions, inhibitions, we can say inhibitions. So this is very important to anyone. So that they are going to find out whether these qualities are there in particular person while they are speaking anyway. Especially the test is in group discussion, because emotions come out when you are speaking, right, among the people, among 10 members, among 20 members. So the group discussion, right, will have that, okay, the group will be about 8 to 10 members, the 20 to 30 minutes, right, the time will be 20 to 30 minutes. That extends to more than that also. Sometimes if you are speaking, all your group members, all 10 members are very tough and very conversative and speaking very good. At the time, they can extend time too. It's not only 20 minutes, but minimum 20 minutes. Depending on the participants, how they are participating, based on that, they go for it. So that's one thing. We can see, definitely, when you are going to face interviews, definitely one or the other company is going to recruit you people by conducting group discussion. Then you understand what I said and what you are going to face, experience. So that's one thing. And without showing our emotions, sometimes we have to condemn some people. We have to reject some people. But it's not direct rejection. How you are going to, what are you using? Excuse me, or it's not like that. According to me, according to my survey, according to so-and-so other, according to so-and-so book, according to so-and-so person, this is this. So that I would like to say that this is right. Like, so in group discussion, you can see pros and cons, everything. It's not bias. It's not bias, something like you no need to speak only one-sided. Like, you can say the opposite points and right supporting points also, opposing points and supporting points also. So that don't worry, debate is that here, debate, in debate you have to choose only one side, bias, just only one-sided. If you choose only supporting points, you have to collect only the supporting points. If you are going to speak on opposing points, you have to collect only opposing points. In group discussion, it's not like that. You have to discuss all the sources, all points from the all corners. Then you have to get solution for it. That's called group discussion. So in the discussion, they find out the leadership qualities, communication skills, language skills, right? Anyhow, your body posture and all these are, that's matter. But how it comes and all, how general sense is important, how common sense is important, we'll see in this. So that here, you can see in English lab group discussion. So what are the points covered here? Just you can check it out once. What are they? Anybody please read out that. What are they in this? What group discussion requires? What recruiters see in you while you are discussing? Can you read out any one of you?
Confidence.
Yes.
Politeness. General, yes. Awareness, leadership skills, teamwork, listening ability, social skills and behavior, problem solving skills and communication skills.
Yeah, these are the main points in any human being. If these are not there, so you are out. Even you have 90% also, they don't care. Even you are extraordinary in something like, also don't care. But what your teamwork is important. Even you don't like somebody, you have to work sometimes. When it comes to professional, in professional life, sometimes we don't like some people. But what happens here, we have to work with the people. So in group discussion, they find whether the person has team working skills or not. That they find it out. And whether the person is speaking politely or not, politeness is there or not. And confidence is there or not. And general awareness, common sense is there or not. Then listening ability is there or not. Actually, this generation losing the listening ability. Always they want to speak, they want to speak something. Just they want to speak. So listening ability means here, that indicates patience. So the listening ability indicates the patience, so that they need the people who have the patience also. And social skills and behavioral skills, how you are moving with the people. Whether you are speaking to only your caste person, whether you are speaking to only your religious person, whether you are speaking to your local person, your area person. So there are many, whether you are speaking only to your country people. So these are all the things are very important when you are going to work in the global world. So these skills are found, these skills are tested in group discussion. So that problem solving skills. So how you are solving? When the person among you, 6 or 10 people, for example, today, we are going to see you there on screen. 6 members are speaking. When 6 members are speaking, so how you are going to behave with the person? For example, controversial topics will be there. Controversial topics. For example, inter-caste marriages, inter-religious marriages. These are controversial. How you are going to face love marriage and arranged marriages? And Telangana state and Andhra state. Many other. So there are many controversial topics are there. In that controversial topics also, how you are going to speak at the time, balancing or not, that matters over there. And overall that comes to problem solving, social behavioral and teamwork, leadership. At last, if 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 skills are there, that comes to leadership skills. So these 8 skills, when the person has these 8 skills, the person becomes leader. So that leadership skills are that. So we had seen that here, the skills, how these are very important for us. And now you can see, this will be the posture. Indeed, it is somewhat formal it only, but the person who is standing over there, the person is a judge. Judge will be at the corner of a room somewhere. Just he will not ask you that here you speak and you speak, you speak, she speaks, something that he doesn't ask anyone. He sits or stands up somewhere else. That's it. He observes. He doesn't say anything. Just he notes down the points, who is who. And your eye contact is important. So when you are speaking, you have to speak all those people, four members, right? When you are speaking to others, only single person looking into the person, and staring also is totally wrong kind of posture. You should not stare into the eyes. You have to change your eyelid, just movement. Staring is some kind of flirting kind of thing. When you are looking into the eyes pleasantly, right? That's very important. So when 6 members or 5 members, 10 members are sitting over there, definitely the person observes who is standing over there. So what are the points you are covering, and whether it is related or not, whether you have that skills, whatever the 8 skills we had seen in the previous slide are there or not, if I answer. So that this is a physical classroom, physical, right, recruitment process when you come to 4th year, that will be there. So it is there in the manual, so that I am handling this topic today. Right, anyhow, presentation skills and all are very important. Then we'll see within this 1 week of time, we'll cover all the topics, no problem at all. So this is one thing. So that your eye contact is important, sitting posture is important. But the lady who is sitting there here, see that here, the brown hair lady's posture is not good. Wantedly, actually I have picked this photograph because I want to show you what is bad posture also. So the person should not cross legs. The crossing legs indicates arrogance. Crossing legs indicates arrogance. So that beside lady also the same. And okay, these 3 gents, okay. But this side, beside the ponytail woman is there, right? Ponytail girl beside that, right? Beard man. His posture is good, but he is completely folding his hands. Right, should not fold hands anytime. It must be open. You have to just use your hand postures. It's fine. Sitting confidently. The blue shirt man sitting confidently. You can see that. So blue shirt man who is there here. So there are different kind of body languages. Right. So that the blue shirt man is right. And beside that, okay, one more man is there. He is right. But these 2 ladies and the one man who is folding hands, not proper body language. So here you understand nonverbal communication is the most important factor in group discussion. How you sit and completely relaxing back also, it's not good. When you totally relaxing back, that means here it's arrogance. You should not relax back anytime when you are speaking to elders or in the meetings. At same time, you should not lean completely down. So when you are leaning completely down, that means here you don't have confidence. So sit appropriately, like the blue shirt man who is there, right? Speak confidently. So that's very important. At same time, you should not touch your nose while speaking, should not touch your hair while speaking, and should not rub your eyes while speaking. So these are all important. Your hand should not go to your face anytime when you are speaking. That is wrong posture again. So there'll be many points. Indeed, if it is physical class, I would have really taken the class with you all. So, but I'm telling you that here, what are the bad postures and what are the good postures? And noting down is important. You must have one scribbling pad always with you, not long notebooks or some right heavy books. Just you carry the scribbling pad whenever you go anywhere. Just you note down the points. That's important to you, so that you can recollect the things. And further, whenever anybody asks you that what happened, this will be the report for the people. So this is good hobby, having the scribbling pad always with you, even in the group discussion or in the classroom meeting. Anyone you are going for formal meeting or informal meeting, scribbling pad is highly dignified thing today. Just don't go with the empty hands, okay, anywhere. So group discussion is that's one. And so postures are like that. Then here, as I told that, what is group discussion here? A group discussion is a form where people sit together, discuss a topic with a common objective of finding a solution for a problem or discussing an issue that is given to the right people. Types of group discussions, as I discussed already, based on group discussion and case study. Case studies are there, group discussion. And most of the management institutes, if you see IIMs, what I said, IIMs and other people who are recruiting that year, they are giving case studies. You know, when you write the CAT exam, you come to know that. In CAT exam, they recruit, they get admitted into the MBA, but there will be one more screening. So they conduct group discussion also. So in that, they find out how you are speaking, because so you are going to lead a company, a big company. If you get MBA in IIMs or management courses, management kind of institutions, so you are going to lead a big company. At the time, how you must be, your posture and your style, your language. So you have to shine always. You have to touchstone your language. That's important. So that how they are recruiting. They are going to conduct a case studies there. They give the only problems. You have to get solution for it. They give some situation, problematic situation. So you have to discuss on that and get solution for that. So how that solution will be very fine. Otherwise, whether it is applicable or practically possible or not, they find it out and select you there. So these are the things. And topic based group discussions, you know, the topics are given, right? Based your topics based JD's group members are given a topic, discuss a topic in typically in the form of a statement. Sometimes the topic may not be a complete statement. For example, the biggest problem faced by our country is, what's that? It is only unending. There is no end to this here. The biggest problem faced by our country is, that is the topic. So how do you speak on that here? So you will have many topics, many points and many topics are here. What is the biggest problem today? COVID situation. At the same time, not getting the vaccination to the people sufficiently. So because 100 crores of people are there, so 100 crores of doses and place 100 crores, 200 crores of doses or doses required. So like this, there'll be many problems. And especially the group discussion topics are asked with the current affairs, so that you have to be always with the right with the newspaper or any kind of news channels. You follow the news channel and read the newspaper regularly, so that they'll ask from the current situations. Especially when they are recruiting, they test only from the outside, social kind of things itself. They don't ask directly to the subject kind of group discussions. They'll ask the social kind of problems. So there'll be political kind of topics, political topics, historical topics. At the same time, social topics, right? Then controversial topics also. So they'll be categorized. So that when you understand that, you are able to read. You find out when you read the newspaper, you find out whether it is social topic, whether it is political topic, whether it is historical topic, whether it is social, controversial topic. So when you read, you understand automatically. No need to classify that this is topic, this topic is this, this topic is this. When you go on reading, you understand which one is controversial, which one is social, which one is so and so like. Then knowledge based topics. So knowledge based topics here, economic topics. Sometimes they ask, if you go to MBA, right, with business schools at the time, they ask you that, right, economic topics. What are the economic topics really are? And social topics are there, political topics, sports, films related topics, IT based, etc., legal topics. So for these 4 years, whatever you studied, right, it's one side. And now when you start reading the newspapers, when you start watching very good news channel, CNN IBN, I recommend CNN IBN and BBC News also, very good. And some people, if you follow that, NDTV also somewhat writing. One more is there, Today, India Today, one more is there. So like some channels, you choose only one channel. Don't switch over to this channel, to that channel and whatever it is. So most of the people cover everything, but okay, CNN IBN presents very good and BBC presents very good. So that you can get from those channels your body posture and how to speak, where to take pause, how to utter a word. All these you learn from watching news channels. So that matters in your professional life at the same time, at the time of recruitment also. So that here, if you see non-knowledge based, what it requires, no need of any knowledge. Simply they can ask anything. Okay, right, discussion on A to Z. It is called abstract topics. Abstract. The topics are totally abstract. So you can't, you'll not find out anything, any points in that. No points, but you have to speak on that. Speak on A to Z. Speak on 1, 2, 3. So I recollect that here. And you are not called by your name in the group discussion, right, in the process of recruitment. Just you are given ABCD, otherwise 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers are given. So based on that numbers or ABCD, something like that alphabet, just they find out, okay, this A got this many points, B got this many points, one got this, two got this, and three got this. So that they don't find out your names, because mostly recruitments are transparently happen. So that you must be very confident and focus very good. This do not require a knowledge base in any specific area for you to be able to talk about them. Common day to day knowledge is sufficient to do good job talking about such topics. Your worldly knowledge and common sense will help you in speaking on the topic. What we discussed that here, common sense is very important to everyone. Sometimes if you don't get some points also, if you have knowledge of outside, definitely you are able to connect that knowledge to the subject. That happens. Even in my case or in any other professional's case also, this will happen. Because you have voracious knowledge. When you have voracious knowledge, sometimes when you are deviating, again you can come back. But when you don't have voracious knowledge, even you deviate and you stuck over there itself. So there ends the matter. That's what you try to get voracious kind of knowledge. Case-based group discussions, case-based studies are important, as I discussed already. So how that case-based discussions are there? As I told you that here, especially IIMs maybe, or the biggest companies who recruit maybe on campus or off campus, they're going to conduct this case-based kind of discussions. Only they give problem, you have to get solution for it. You discuss and get the solution. Even sometimes they give lively problems also. Even those days, I think you might be in your schooling. Satyam Ramalinga Raju, how many of you know? I don't know. So that there was one case, Satyam Computers, the biggest software industry at the time. So from Andhra Pradesh especially, who established. So all the other companies from North India, some other corner of nation. But Satyam company from Andhra Pradesh, okay. But unfortunately, something happened, the crisis, it was into crisis. At the time, most of the companies asked this case-based kind of group discussions. They gave this case-based. So why Satyam Ramalinga Raju's company was totally sold out for Tech Mahindra? What's the problem? If you would be there at that situation, what would be the solution for that? So this live kind of things. And we can see in your right generation also, you might have seen Siddhartha. Coffee Day Siddhartha. How many of you know Coffee Day Siddhartha? Anybody went to Coffee Day? Okay, it's okay. So Coffee Day Siddhartha situation. What about Coffee Day Siddhartha situation? Why he was into bankruptcy? What happened to him? At last he committed suicide. So if you are there in Siddhartha's position, what would be the solution for Coffee Day? That's case based. So like this, the discussion will go on. That's what you have to always keep in touch with the current affairs, day-to-day happening things in the world and nation, at the same time, regional also. And moderators. So moderators, we can come to the people here, how this group discussion is conducted and how, what kind of people they will be there. One is moderator, one is sponge listener, one is, okay, active listener, right? Active listener, sponge listener, moderator. So sponge listeners just listen. Even sometimes if they are given chance also, they can't speak. Always will be like that. Stone listeners. So stone listeners can't speak anything. Even 20 minutes or 30 minutes also, just simply sitting over there. Those kind of people are not recruited. The sponge listeners are that here. If they are asked to speak, yes, it's right. So, okay, I felt same. Thank you. So these kind of simple words they use, they are called sponge listeners, stone listeners, as you know that. And active listeners are there. They'll be listening to the complete discussion actively. At same time, they will take it further and they move forward like moderators. So moderators are very important. So the initiators, concluders are important like moderators. So initiators who take initiative to speak, no need to conclude. The people who could not initiate, no need to conclude. At the same time, concluders may not, right, initiate. Otherwise, initiator may be the concluder also. no problem. But when the person is coming to conclude, he has to raise all the points what are discussed in the group. That's important. And initiator who is taking that lead and giving the topic to many people, that person must have command over the topic. Then only has to be initiator. Simply, I want to initiate, sir. It's not like. So initiator is a person who will have more points than other moderators and other people. And concluder will also have more points. Concluder and initiators will have more points. So that you don't think that, here, sir, I want to be concluder, I want to be initiator, so that concluder will not speak entire discussion and initiator will not speak after the initiative. It's not like that. Initiator also has to participate till the end of discussion, and concluder also has to listen to it carefully, and at last he has to discuss everything along with the people, and he has to end the topic at the end. So that these kind of people. So concluders are there, initiators are there, moderators are there, sponge listeners are there, okay, stone listeners are there, active listeners are there. So stone listeners don't have chance to get into the company, and sponge listeners also will be failures. So you have to be moderator, initiator, concluder, and active listeners and participants. That's very important here. And strategies, how you are going to face here. Well, the topic for discussion is chosen. The candidate has to decide either to speak in favor or the topic against the topic. So this is indeed, the point is not relevant indeed. But sometimes if you have only supporting points, you go on and speak. If you have only against points, you can go on and speak. Don't worry about it. Don't worry whether I speak this one or other. Even you speak both the points, against points and supporting points also, no worry about it. Just simply go on there. The candidate should have sufficient facts either to contradict or they support the issue also. The language should be simple and lucid. No need to go for bombastic language and complex sentences, compound sentences. Don't try and don't wait to get right kind of sentences. The language must be like flow. Lucid, very clear. Lucid means here, very clear and very simply it should go on like. The candidate should be tactful while contradicting the views of the other participants. Blunt statements such as "your arguments are baseless" or "you are absolutely wrong" is not in a good taste. So that you have to feel, you don't give right blunt answers. "Hey, you are not right, go away." These kind of arrogant answers are not required, especially at the time of recruitment. So after getting into professional life, how that professional life and that right environment changes, that's a different case. But at the time of recruitment, definitely you have to be very careful that you have to say everything that you're okay, thank you, thanks for your right suggestion. Like always, you have to go on like. The candidate has to disagree without sounding rude by saying things such as I beg to differ, and pardon, I would like to. So whatever the polite sentences you can use in that way. So some patterns of starting to discussion here. We have assembled here how you start a discussion. How you start a discussion, you don't go simply like that. How it is, some patterns of starting a discussion. We have assembled here to discuss. So these are all the phrases. You can use any phrase in this when you are going to initiate the discussion. We are assembled here to discuss. Let us get down to business. Shall we set the ball rolling? Shall we make a start? Some patterns for interrupting a discussion. Sorry to. So that was, those statements are for starting. When you want to interrupt a discussion, sometimes the discussion is continuously going on. The person is not giving chance. At the time you can interrupt also, but how you have to interrupt? Those are the statements here. Sorry to interrupt you. Excuse me, but could I make a suggestion, please? Could I say something? Sorry to disagree with you. If I could make a point here. So like, these are the interrupting phrases. So the above things are initiative, how you initiate, and the other ones, how you interrupt when the person is not giving chance to speak to you. The next, you can see time slot, how the time would be there. What time allotment? So it may be 15 to 20 minutes as we discussed, 15 to 20 minutes. So within 20 minutes, you have to frame your mind to speak and collect the points and all. You prepare like that. But if the discussion is outstanding, that may be extended up to half an hour also, 40 minutes also. That depends on all the candidates who speak in that. So variations in the time that is allowed for the discussion and all, that's important and should bear the mind is that the time required for the discussion does not depend on the group size, whatever it is. Okay, whatever the size of the group, 15 to 25 minutes is what is normally required for a group discussion. Sometimes the moderator may not pre-specify the duration of the group discussion also, so that no worry about time, but you must be confident and very clear about your goals and other things. How to improve your performance in group discussion? So this is the first thing here. Everybody, sir, I am not getting confidence. So I remember one time, one Pawan Kalyan dialogue. So the person who has content, no need of cutout. So just only the person has that content, that's enough. So that here, the person who has content, the confidence comes automatically. Confidence comes through knowledge. It doesn't come from outside. It's not in the market to buy. So that here, first of all, you spend some time to gain knowledge. When you have knowledge, automatically that communication skills come. If you don't have knowledge about so-and-so topic, if I ask you to speak about print media, if you don't know anything about print media, what is print media also, if you don't know, what you speak about it, you can't speak. That's what confidence comes through knowledge only. Knowledge is gained. Wisdom is given. So wisdom is given, knowledge is gained. Wisdom is given by hereditary from our grandparents and parents, right? But knowledge is gained. So knowledge and wisdom together, that you are going to communicate with the people. That's great opportunity for you all. So that now that we have understood what group discussion are all about and what the moderator looks for in the participants, let us understand how you can enhance your performance in a GD, right? Then these are all there here. And topics, there are three different aspects that you should take care of to improve your performance in GDs. They are here: building your knowledge base, generating ideas about the topic, improving your participation in GD, displaying position body language, respecting the opinions of others participants, being polite with the other participants. So this is about overall, how should we behave? What are the etiquettes of group discussion? Of course, all of you understood that. So definitely you are going to speak now. Very good. Now let us start with the people, right? The presentations also. I hope most of the people are going to present today. Surely this ELCS lab class definitely will give you scope to speak better. Thank you so much. Yeah, it's about overall. Now let us come to the point. Who will be the first six? Who will be the first six candidates? And I request again all of you, you have to. What do you have to? On
your turn on the videos.
Yeah, turn on the videos and speak. Then it will be fine for you also when you see or when you show to your